Heanie, could you first of all spell your name for me?
H-E-A-N-I-E. Right. Last name is Staheli, S-T-A-H-E-L-I. Yes, we were.
Can you tell me about your student?
We had Nick Hutchings. He came in from Anchorage. His mother and father were both lawyers. He was 16 when he was here. I don't know what else you want me to tell you about him.
Good. How was it for him?
It was different. It was different for Nick to just come into our home. And that was when he came in, I told him one of the first things was that we were going to treat him like he was one of our children. He had to abide by our house rules, and he had to work with the family and be part of the family if he wanted to be with us, be part of us, to learn about our culture.
You were pretty accepting of that?
He was. Yeah, and he actually fit in really easily, which surprised us. Yeah, he fit in real easy.
I'm going to cut right to the chase now. And this might be a tough one, but how do you prepare to be a host parent?
That is a really hard question. You have to be open, is one thing. And just to be able to kind of spend a little time with him when your student first comes, to see what they're like and see what their expectations are, see what they're kind of expecting to do. And, you know, the people from the humanities says, well, you know, you don't have to prepare any special food for him or anything, but it would have been nice to know what some of his favorites were so that we could kind of blend it in so that he didn't feel like such an outsider. That is something that I would have liked to have done. But to find his interests and do something that he was comfortable doing made it nice.
Did you get one of those booklets? You got one of those booklets, I'm assuming?
On
the humanities forum saying not prepared.
Yeah.
Did that help out at all?
Yeah, it did. It did, but there was a lot of anticipation. We were worried. I was worried about whether he was going to like it or not, or whether we can keep him occupied, or yeah. So there was some worry there, but the booklet did help. But there's a lot of things you don't plan on. That, you know, no matter how well the book was written, something always comes up.
What about fitting in? I mean, was it kind of? Did you have to take him around and show him around?
Yes, we did, and it was different for him to see the openness in our community. Everybody was saying hi. By the end of the first day, I think all the kids knew his name, and he was kind of lost. It was like everybody would come up and say, "Oh, hi, Nick," and he was like, "Hi." You know, not knowing, you know, what the kids' name were or any of their background. And everybody knew in town who he was and what he was doing and how long he was going to be here. And so that was different for him to have everybody know everything about him. And he was kind of, I think he was kind of lost then. He was like, oh, they know who I am.
How did you prepare his living quarters?
We moved him into my son's room. And so my son is 11, or he was 10 then. So he stayed in my son's room by himself. We tried to give him some space so that he had time to do his own thing, because he was keeping a journal, and he was really good at that. We never had to get after him about doing any of the stuff, you know, that they asked him to do, like the journal and keeping track. And so that was nice. He did that in the evenings and in the morning, so it kind of gave him his own space.
Did you have to change your daily routine, your life at all?
None. We didn't have to do any changes at all. No changes. He just fit right in. Like I said, he jumped in, And there were some things that he said, oh, don't fix anything for me. I won't be eating that, or I don't eat that. And once we started making it, he was going, that's not so bad. So, no, I would say there was no big changes that we had to do. Of course, we had teenagers in the house already, so our lifestyle was fit around our children anyways. So he fit in.
Did the kids pretty much take over as hosts?
Yes and no. Lee took Nick and went all over with Nick when he was here. That's my husband. And in the afternoon, the kids would go out and do stuff with him. They'd take him out. But as far as the kids taking over the whole thing, no, they didn't. We do a lot of things with our kids now. If you're around here, you'll see, you'll notice that everything that we do as a family. We're able to do that living here in the village. It's not all driving the kids back and forth. There is no driving, so you spend a lot of time just doing things. So that's something that's different coming from the city life that he noticed, was there was no driving time, no sitting there and taking 20 minutes to get from one place or another.
How about preparation? Was there any communication before he came out here?
Yes, we did, and that was really nice. They hooked us up with Nick, and he sent us several letters, and then we got in touch by email. And that made it nice, because we were able to kind of get a feel for what his personality was like. So that was nice, being able to talk to him before he got here.
Helped out a lot.
Yes.
Was there any kind of other kind of special preparation before he got here, or as he was getting here?
No, we didn't do any special preparation. Like I said, he just kind of fit in. I brought him over to the house and said, and went over the layout of the house, and this is where you're going to stay. And he, we just kind of went over the house rules real quick and said that, this is kind of what we expect of you. And we told him, if you have any problems, don't keep it in. Come out and tell us right away, hey, I'm not comfortable with that, or, I don't really care for that. So that made it easier. And the other thing was, if you don't like what I cook, there's the kitchen. You need to make yourself at home and just make something that you are comfortable with eating.
Can you give me an example of some of the house rules that were like
that? One was the curfew. We expect our children to be in at curfew. And the other thing is to help out. When everybody's done with dinner, you get up and you help put everything away. You help doing the dishes, help clean up. Just if you see something that needs to be done, don't wait for somebody to ask you. Just jump in like you are one of the kids and do it.
And how was he about that?
Really good. He was really good about it. We own a business here, and he jumped right in. And he was helping out with the business, and it was nice to be able to work with a teenager that could take a set of instructions and work with it. You didn't have to say, oh, this is how you do it. He was very capable of following instructions and, a really quick learner. Hi, Nick. That's Nick. Real quick.
How were you prepared for emergency situations?
We had a really nice card that the humanities put together, and it was all of Nick's emergency information. And we stuck that right by the phone. So that was nice. It was all prepared. There was no thought involved. There was a number that you called, and thank God nothing happened while he was here. But everything was all laid out. He got here, and he had a calling card to be able to call home. You know, so that was nice. Somebody really took the time to think of all the different things that he might need while he was here.
About how would you handle homesickness?
Keeping him busy, keeping his mind occupied is the way that I found works the best. If a child has idle time, they will get homesick and start thinking about the things. But if you take them out in the country and start showing them different things, they get their mind off being homesick. Even if it's just talking about one of his hobbies that he does, or trying to get him to open up and get his mind off being homesick, I think is the best way to handle that, just keeping him occupied.
Subsistence activities. Did you get involved in those things?
We did. We took Nick out. We do a lot of berry picking here. So we took him out, and he actually got into it. He did very well. Then we went as far as preparing something with them. And so when he got ready to go home, we made him a box of stuff that we had done while he was here. We did some fishing, and Nick and I cut up the fish, and we got it all prepared, ready for him to cook. We breaded it and got it all ready. So we wrote up the instructions so that when he got home, he can share some of his experiences with his parents. Because when you're a teenager, when you go out on a trip, your parents automatically ask you, well, what'd you do? And you go, well, gosh, let me think. And so this was kind of a little reminder. We made him a care package for him to take home of the different things that we did together. And we made him a little recipe card so he could try it, you know, take it home and see if he would cook it for his parents. So that was something that we did. We went out and we went fishing and put a lot of berries away while he was here. And we weren't able to do any hunting at the time because he came during the middle of the summer, and we don't do that here. But we did share with him our traditional foods that we had gathered, you know, during their season. So he was able to try the different things.
What kind of things were you anticipating? Do you have any concerns or worries?
I was very worried about having another teenager into my home. Like I said, we have a business, and so it was hard. I was really worried about having another kid come in, because it is so hard. Teenagers, you know, at that age, you don't really know what to expect. They're so different. And so I was very worried about how he would fit in and if we were able to meet his expectations.
Concerned at all about having enough time to spend with him?
We are very busy, and I was, you know, we would make time to close up in the evening. Oh, maybe.
You aren't having it, right?
No. I just picked it up when you...
Excellent.
We were very worried about having enough time for Nick when he was here because we are so busy during the day. But we made a point to close up in the evening and make time to go out. So that was nice. We didn't do it the whole time he was here, but we did make free time in the evenings.
And overall, how was the experience? How would you rate it?
It was great. The people at the Humanities, they put together really nice packets. So when he got here, he was fully prepared. He had a camera. He had his helmet that they require him to use. So there was no trying to rush around and find anything for him. He had everything when he got here. So that was nice.
Would you recommend this for other families?
I would. I would, especially since he got to be good friends with the kids, and the kids did a lot of talking to him and realized that there was more to life than just the village life, that you know, when you go to the city, you actually see it in a different light because of the experiences that Nick shared of the city life when he was here, stuff that, you know, my kids hadn't even thought of before. So that was nice that they were able to compare different things, and so the kids got to, like I said, see the city life in a different way.
I'm sure it was a learning experience for Nick as well. But how about for you?
Oh, it was. It was a learning experience, and it was something that I would try again. He was very personable to have around, and so being my first host student, he made it really nice, enjoyable.
Well, I think we might just get another student. I think he hears that one. The honest answer. How hard is it to be a host?
Oh, it's very easily. Just keep your mind open. And try to, it's so easy to get into the mode of doing anything, you know, just the simple things that you do every day, to stop and tell him a little bit about it, him or her about it. And because you get into the habit of doing things and you don't realize that maybe he's never seen that done before, or he doesn't know why you are doing these things. So it made me look at different things that I do through his eyes. What is she doing? You know, to take the time and say, oh, this is why I'm doing this. So, yeah, it did. Made me look at our whole country here in different eyes.
That was kind of, that was, he had the need or desire to call home.
You know, I was trying to remember if he did. I do know that he emailed his mother while he was here, and he was sending her notes that way. But I was trying to remember, you know, I don't think he actually called home when he was here.
This is a lot right there. And,
okay, one way. Okay. Do you know when you want to come back? Okay.
What a crazy world we're living in. Love has no chance to win. I ask you, what chance have I? When each love I meet just makes me cry.
And she would like to return Tuesday, the 15th.
Hi, Tom.
To be true.
I don't think so. Who do you show?
Yeah. Do you show anybody for this afternoon?
No.
Ida Stoney. I think Giselle's talking to Tom and I'm talking to you.
Ida Stoney? Okay. Okay. I got CAVU and they're down to the board about 10.
I just showed Charlie Curtis.
Yeah. Okay, thank you, Tom.
Thank you.
Are you guys off yet?
Bye-bye. We're returning Tuesday. 305. Yes, and you will be here today. Okay, 128 round trip.
Yes, step.
You going to be your son going to bring you up tomorrow? Thanks, Hill.
Spend a few hours in the trucks, huh?
How anybody.
Want me back here or where do you want me?
Yeah, maybe.
Thank you. Got a few, huh?
Maybe. That's a snag, I think. Snakes. I'll just cut it. Cut it to that difference. Just put it in the sandbox. Okay.
Get here.
Bokestall vi många jolie.